ओम नमो ब्रह्मादिभ्यो ब्रह्म विद्या संप्रदाय कर्तृभ्यो शर्षिभ्यो महद्भ्यो नमो गुरुभ्यः सर्वोपप्लवरितः अज्ञानं प्रत्यकर्तुः ब्रह्मैवाहमस्मि नारायणं पद्मभुवं वसिष्ठं शक्तिं च तत्पुत्रपराशरं च व्यासं शुकं गौडपदं महान्तं गोविन्दयोगीन्द्रमथास्य शिष्यं श्रीशङ्कराचार्यमथास्य पद्मपादं च हस्तामलकं च शिष्यम् तन्तोटकं वार्तिककारमन्यानस्मद्गुरून् सन्ततमानतोऽस्मि श्रुतिस्मृतिपुराणानाम् आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शङ्करं लोकशङ्करं शङ्करं शङ्कराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वन्दे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेदविभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै ॐ शान्तिश्शान्तिश्शान्तिः यद्ब्रह्मगोचरविचित्रतमः प्रभावात् संसारधीजनितदुःखमभूज्जनस्य यद्ब्रह्मधीजनितसौख्यमभूच्च तस्य तं रुक्मिणी सहितकृष्णमहं नमामि यमिह कारुणिकं शरणं गतोऽप्यरीसहोदरापमहत्पदम् नमहमाशु हरिं परमाश्रये जनकजाङ्कमनन्त सुखाकृतिम् लुकिंग एट दी हेतुस गिवन बाय दी पूर्व पक्षी टू से दैट पराक्तम ऑफ आत्मा इज नॉट पॉसिबल and the refutation thereof. So it was said that Atma cannot be Pratyang Atma, the Paraktum of Vishaya, Yushmat Pratyay Gochara, and Pratyaktum of Atma, Asmat Pratyay Gochara, which was mentioned. That is Asiddha. And hetu given was ahamiti pratyamanatvat. So the atma is also known as aham, just like ahankara is yatha ahankara. Therefore atma cannot be pratyang atma. Ahankara is parak, it is outward. Atma also cannot be inward, it has to be outward, because ahamiti pratyamanatvam is there. There, what is the meaning of this ahamiti pratyamanatvam? Whether it is aham vritti vyangya spuranatvam or spurana vishayatvam, that was asked. And then the doshas were shown in that hetu. If you take any paksha, if you take aham vritti vyangya spuranatvam, meaning manifest by aham vritti, then in drishtanta ahankara there is no manifestation. Ahankara is what it is, it does not manifest as anything. Ahamvritti does not manifest ahankara, because ahankara is jada, it cannot manifest in spurana. There cannot be spurana of ahankara, it is jada. There is no chaitanya spurana in ahankara. Similarly, if you take the other option and say spurana vishayatvam as a hetu, ahamiti pratyamanatvam means spurana vishayatvam, then ahankara is vishaya for spurana, all right, chaitanya, but chaitanya itself is not the spurana vishaya, it is not the object of chaitanya. Chaitanya is not the object of chaitanya itself, therefore your hetu falls apart. Then vishayini, what was said there, it was said atma's vishayitvam, that atma is a vishayi, that is also not right, says the Purvapakshi. Why? Anubhavami iti shabdavatvat. We see the prayoga anubhavami. So when you say anubhavami, you cannot be a vishayi. How so? Because your anubhava, you are the vishaya of your anubhava. So that kind of thinking is there. So vishayitvam cannot be there. Vishayatvam is possible, not vishayitvam. So then, basically, what is the idea there? When you use the shabda anubhavami, then atma anubhava, That is the kind of usage you have atmanubhava. So anubhava means the shabda anubhava leads to atma. Therefore it is vishaya, not a vishayi. So there the question is whether it is by vishaya, by vachyartha, or by lakshyartha. If you say it is vachyartha, shabdena vyavahriyamanatvat vachyartha, then vachyartha being the hetu, paksha is atma. In atma, vachyartha isn't there. Brahma is not the vachyartha of Brahma itself. Similarly, atma, which is non-different from Brahma, is not the vachyartha of the word atma itself. Let alone any other word, atma itself. Forget about anubhavam ityadi. Just atma shabda also cannot lead to the meaning of atma by vachyartha. Even satchit ananda, if you say, although they are swarupa lakshana, still satchit ananda is also not giving the vachyartha of brahmatma. It is not possible. In which case, the paksha atma ni tan nasti, vachyartham nasti, vachyartha isn't there. Shruti also says that. So we have basis in Shruti, yato vacho nivartante, iti Shruti. Then if the Puro Pakshi were to say, no, I meant laksharatham, atma is a laksharatha of sanubhavami shabda, then paksha atma has laksharatha, but then drishtanta ahankara does not have laksharatha. When you say ahankara anubhavami, then the ahankara is having anubhava. There is no laksharatha, there is no other. Because ahankara, when you say aham anubhava, guna guneshu vartante, there the ahankara is the anubhava vishaya. Thereby, sukham anubhavami, all these ideas when you talk about, then ahankara is what is the vachyartha there, not laksharatha. Therefore, hetu falls apart. So that was the refutation of the second hetu for vishayitvam being objected to. Now further, In the Tika, Vishayitvam. So yesterday we saw this should be Vishayitvam. Vishayitvam means Vishaya Vishayinor Iti Bhashyena Uktam Vishayitvam Ityartha. This also should be Vishayitvam, because in the Ratna Prabha you have Vishayitvam. Yad Atmana Vishayitvam, Atmana Vishayitvam would be wrong. Unless, you know, he is taking some other word which I am unable to find there as Vishayatvam. But here, this Nanu, the objection raised, there is only this Vishayatvam word. The Vishayatvam is there earlier in Spurana Vishayatvam. That has already been discussed in the earlier Hetu. So, it has to be Vishayatvam. So, Shabdavatvat, and he is dealing with the second Hetu. Shabdavatvat, that is the Hetu. Shabdavatvat kim? Shabdavatvat. अनुभवामि इति शब्दवत्वात् आत्मनः विषयित्वाभावः. दैट वाज द साध्य फॉर द हेतु गिवन एज अनुभवामि इति शब्दवत्वात्. दैट शब्दवत्व, व्हाट इज दैट शब्दवत्वात्? शब्देन व्यवह्रियमाणत्वा इत्यर्थः. सो शब्दवत्वात् मीनिंग हैविंग द शब्द, मीनिंग बीइंग एबल टू यूज दिस शब्द इज द हेतु रिगार्डिंग आत्मा. सो शब्देन शब्देन व्यवह्रियमाणत्वात्. शब्देन व्यवह्रियमाणत्वम् मीन्स् वाट् नाउ? नाम शब्दवाच्यत्वं शब्दलक्ष्यत्वं वा इति विकल्प्य हेतुं स्वयं दूषयति वाच्यत्वम् इति कल्पितत्वात्. सो वी ऑलरेडी सॉ दिस इन दि रत्नप्रभा इट्सेल्फ एज टू स्वयमेव दूषयति. हि रिफ्यूट्स दिस बाय क्रिएटिंग दि टू ऑप्शंस टू अंडरस्टैंड दि हेतु बेटर. Siddhanti asks whether it is Vachyatvam or Lakshyatvam, and then Vachyatvam, if he says Vachyatvam, Vachyatvam iti kalpitatvat. What is Vachyatvam of Atma? Atma does not have Vachyatvam. Whatever has Vachyatvam is all kalpita. Why? Vacharambhano vikaro namadhyam. Akaro vai sarva vak sri chandogya shruti. And in Shashtodhyaya, you also have in Chandogya Shruti, इट्स सेइंग वाचारंभणम विकारो नामधेयम सो नाम मात्रम एवरीथिंग विच इज अ वाच्यार्थ इज ऑल बिगन विथ वाच वाचारंभण आरंभण इज अ सेंस ऑफ आलंबन देयर रलयोर अभेद दैट कैन ऑल्सो बी कंसिडर्ड एंड देन वाचारंभण मीन्स वाच वाक आलंब आरंभ आलंबनम यस्य यस्य प्रपंचस्य एनीथिंग दैट हैज वाच्यार्थ इज ऑल कल्पिता बिकॉज इट इज ऑल जस्ट हैविंग अ वर्ड देयर इज नथिंग एल्स देयर इज नो रियल एग्जिस्टेंस सत्ता इज बोरोड इट इज ऑल मिथ्या नाम रूपात्मक प्रपंच इज नाम मात्र रियली नॉट इवन रूप रूप ऑल्सो इफ यू इंक्वायर इन टू फर्दर रूप इज अ भ्रांति इफ यू लुक एट दी घटा the shape of the ghata also roopa of the ghata is not the its own roopa also although roopa is said to be mithya the roopa is mithya by association with the ghata the ghata roopa is mithya but if you look at roopa in the adhisthana which can take any roopa so therefore that roopa is mithya it is ever changing the mrut can be shaped up so the mrut roopa is also mithya But in the context of the ghata rupa, it is mithya, it is further mithya because it does not have its own rupa. It appears to have rupa, which is nothing but the rupa borrowed from the adhisthana as well. Which adhisthana? That mrud adhisthana, which itself does not have any sthira rupa. Therefore, rupa is mithya there also, but in the karya, rupa is further mithya. So, what the Chandogya Upanishad says that it collapses the Nama Rupa also into only Nama. Rupa need not be talked about. There is nothing called as Rupa. Because Rupa is Asthira, there is no Satta of Rupa. Nama, if you talk about, Nama gives the Rupa a reality. Whereas Rupa does not have any reality at all, this Nama, what is its basis which gives, as though gives reality to something? That Nama is nothing but ending with closing the mouth, which will become makara. So when you open the mouth, you will get akara. When you close the mouth, you will get makara. And everything in between is considered as ukara. In Chandogya and Mandukya Upanishad also. So a, u and ma. Akara, ukara and makara, all three put together, you will get om. You will get gunasandhi and it will become om. So everything, every padartha is non-different from pada. Puramimamsaka says that every padartha is nothing but has a nitya sambandha with pada. And Mandukya further confirms this and says that in fact, forget about nitya sambandha, there is nothing called as padartha other than pada. Which is itself वाक आलंबनम यस्य पदस्य पदार्थस्य सो पदार्थ हैज बेसिस इन पदा पदा इज नथिंग बट नाम सेड एल्सवेयर एंड ओम ऑल्सो इज रिप्रेजेंटेड बाय अकार ओनली अकार वाई सर्वा वाक एवरी थिंग दैट इज स्पोकन बिगिन्स विथ अकार इज ऑल कोलैप्स इन टू ओम विच इज रिप्रेजेंटेड एज बाय अकार इन छांदोग्य सो अकार वाई Indeed, everything is sarva vak. All vak is nothing but akara, omkara. And this has basis on, this padartha has basis on vak, which is omkara, which is nama, which is itself. Without uttering anything, there cannot be anything present. This uttering can be, utterance can be subtle also. It need not be only vaikari. It can be subtle utterance also, madhyama, etc. So with that basis, this shabda vyavahara gocharattvam which is there, vachyatvam, that is kalpita. And atma is not kalpita. So swayam dusheti vachyatvam iti, vachyatvam hetu or lakshatvam hetu, shabda vachyatvam, shabda lakshatvam. If you say shabda vachyatvam, then In the Ratna Prabha there is a refutation, but Tikakara says Vachyatvam iti kalpitatvat. This Vachyatvam of Atma is kalpita. आत्मा इज नॉट वाच्यार्थ एंड एनीथिंग दैट इज वाच्यार्थ इज एक्चुअली कल्पित, आत्मा इज नॉट कल्पित। सो यद्यपि विषयित्वं विशिष्ट प्रमातृ चैतन्यस्य एव न तु केवल अहंकारस्य तथापि विशिष्टे पर्याप्तं विषयित्वं अहंकारे विशेषेण अपि विद्यते इति अभिप्रेत्याह देहमिति। नाउ देयर इज एन ऑब्जेक्शन टू दिस रिफ्यूटेशन आल्सो। दिस विषयित्वं विच इज बीइंग टॉक्ड अबाउट as to what this vishayatvam in ahankara, how can you talk about ahankara as the vishaya? The Purvapakshi says you the siddhanti are claiming that atma has vishayatvam whereas anatma has vishayatvam, ahankara buddhi all has vishayatvam. Now he says I'll show you how अहंकार इज ऑल्सो विषय, सो दैट यूर रिफ्यूटेशन एंड देयर बाय एस्टैब्लिशिंग दी विषयित्व ऑफ आत्मा फॉल्स अपार्ट और योर विषयित्व ऑफ आत्मा इट्सेल्फ फॉल्स अपार्ट। हाउ सो? दिस विषयित्व विल लीड टू अहंकार ऑल्सो। इफ आई शो यू दैट अहंकार इज विषय, बुद्ध्यादि अहंकार इज विषय, देन you cannot say that only atma is vishayi, therefore vishayi vishayino ho virodha you cannot show because ahankara will also become vishayi. How so? So in the moola it has been said, he introduces that, so tikakar is introducing that section. This vishayitva in the case of atma is by ahankara as vishaya. Whereas ahankara can be the vishayi when you look at everything outside the ahankara, everything outside the ahankara, the sharira. You know your sharira in your antakarna. So you have buddhi which can think about what your sharira looks like. That time the sharira is the vishaya. And your buddhi ahankara, where you are in having tadatmya sambandha, you say that I know my body. I am tall. I am a manushya, etc. So there, I am tall, I am manushya will come to later. But then, you know I have a human body. So that is the sentence you have to take for analysis here. When you say that, I am looking at this human body of mine, I am looking at my dark or fair skin, which is the sharira. It is the sharira's rupa, color. So that time your ahankara is the vishayi, sharira is the vishaya. Then vishayitvam of ahankara is also proven, not of atma alone. Therefore there is no virodha. Iti chet. So if this is the objection, what is being said in the tikakara says, yadyapi vishayitvam, what is this vishayitvam? In the atma's case also vishayitvam that we talk about is not kevala atma. And in your case also it is not like that. So what is it? Yadyapi vishayitvam vishishta pramatru chaitanyasya eva natu kevala ahankarasya. The kevala ahankara cannot be vishayi, cannot be vishaya also, just kevala as a vishayi. In the case of sharira also kevala ahankara is not the vishayi because it is jada. However, so what the hetu which was given in the Ratna Prabha, what was said there? Nantya drishtantya tadvaikalyad iti bhava. Drishtanta is ahankara. And in ahankara, what is the vikalattum there? The hetu vaikalya is there. So hetu was given as vachyartha. Then that time pakshetada siddhi. In atma, there is no vachyartha. But in, if you take the second option, lakshattum hetu, then lakshattum is not there in ahankara. So by lakshana you cannot take ahankara, meaning ahankara is vachyartha. That was the vaikalya shown there, vikalattvam. Even in the that case when you say that ahankara is vishayi, what happens is that there is a mix-up. So we'll go ahead and then come back to the tika because it has a little dependency on this. देहं जानामि इति देहांकारयोर विषय विषयित्वे अपि. सो देह एंड अहंकार, देह बिटवीन देह एंड अहंकार ऑल्सो देर इज सम संबंध. बिटवीन अहंकार एंड आत्मा वॉट इज द संबंध? विषय विषय संबंध. एंड दे हैव विरोध. दिस इज द कॉन्टेक्स्ट ऑफ द अध्यास भाष्य. नाउ इफ यू टेक देह एंड अहंकार दैट इज ऑल्सो पेयर विच हैज सेम संबंध विषय 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 संबंध. देर बाय द विषयित्व एंड विषयत्व Virodha that you are showing won't be there if I switch the pair and show you that Vishayi can be Ahankara also. So, Deham Janami, I know my body. So, which the example I said, know my body in the sense, I know the color of the body, etc. I am fat, thin, whatever one has ideas about. That is the idea about the body. So, there he says, I know my body. But then, That body is a manushya sharira. So, deham janam iti dehankarayor vishaya vishayitve api. Even if the deha is vishaya of ahankara, in the deham janami, and thereby ahankara is a vishayi, not a vishaya, tathapi, manushyoham iti abhedadhyasavat atma ahankarayor api adhyasasyadityatah. So just like manushya aham, that kind of sambandha, tadatmya sambandha can be there even when there is a virodha. So one thing is that atma is a vishayi, similarly ahankara is a vishayi. Atma is a vishayi for ahankara as vishaya. Similarly ahankara is a vishayi for deha as vishaya. That's one part. Second part is that even if ahankara is a vishayi, There is no virodha with the deha, which is vishaya. Why so? You are showing the virodha, but there is no virodha. Why so? There is tadatmya sambandha. How is it there? Manushyaham. So when you say manushyaham, manushya is what? Manushya is deha dharma. Manushyattvam is deha dharma. Therefore, manushya is deha. Atma is not manushya. Atma is not deha. But still, ahankara also is not deha. Ahankara is not manushya. Manushya is only the stula sharira. But still, there is tadatmya sambandha between the stula sharira and ahankara. Ahankara is this individual ego. So when it manifests this buddhi as aham, ahankara, I am, I exist, I am a man, then you say, I am a man, I am a woman. So there, what have you done? I am a human being. As soon as you have uttered, I am a human being, the vishaya, manushya sharira, has had tadatmya sambandha, where there was vishaya vishaya vishayi sambandha, now that has graduated to tadatmya sambandha bheda sahita abheda. If that kind of sambandha can take place between vishaya and vishayi in the case of deha and ahankara, why can't it take place in the case of vishaya and vishayi, the pair being ahankara and atma? So this is the second part. So even if you show that Atma is Vishayi to Ahankara is Vishaya, there can be a Tadatmya Sambandha and thereby no Virodha. Tamah Prakashavat Virodha Nasti. This is the Purvapakshi's perspective. Thereby he says Manushya Aham Iti Abheda Adhyasavad. Abheda Adhyasa is Tadatmya Sambandha. Abheda Sahita Abheda. Atma Ahankara Yorapi Adhyasa Syadityata Aha Chidatmake Iti. Therefore, Bhagavan Bhashyakara knows this objection is there. Therefore, he says, Chidatmake. This Ahankara is Jada. So, between Jada and Jada, there may be Tadatmya Sambandha. Although there is Vishay Vishay Sambandha that you are showing. Vishay Vishay Sambandha is also not really the way you understand it. You can't just directly extend it to Atma. Because the difference is Atma is Chaitanya and the Vishaya of that Atma is Jada. In your example case, there is a vyabhichara. There is a the example is not proper because in your example both are jada. Whereas in the extension to the exemplified, in the exemplified one is chetana, the other is jada. Vishaya is jada, vishaya is chetana. In your case, both the vishaya and vishayi are jada. So now we look at the tika. यद्यपि विषयित्वं विशिष्ट प्रमात्र चैतन्यस्य एव दिस विषयित्वं दैट यू टॉक अबाउट अहंकार दैट अहंकार इज नॉट शुद्ध अहंकार केवल अहंकार केवल केवल अहंकारस्य विषयित्वं नास्ति विशिष्ट प्रमात्र चैतन्यस्य एव अस्ति सो विशिष्ट प्रमात्र चैतन्य इज द विषयी केवल अहंकार इज नॉट द विषयी द अहंकार बिकम्स द विशेषण टू द चैतन्य प्रमात्र चैतन्य दैट अहंकार एंड देयरफॉर बिकम्स द प्रमाता रियली सो प्रमाता हैविंग बिकम प्रमाता देन अलोन यू से दैट आई एम knowing I know the deha deham janami aham janami how do you say that when there is antakarna ahankara which becomes the visheshana to the chaitanya and thereby you get ahankara avachinna chaitanya but how is it avachinna visheshanatvena therefore this ahankara gets the padvi of pramata and then becomes a vishayi of this deha, which is vishaya. Tathapi vishishte paryaptam vishayitvam ahankare visheshena api vidyate. So being the visheshana, this vishayitvam of the chaitanya has extended or has been borrowed in the visheshana, whereas the visheshitvam is really due to chaitanyatvam. Of the Adhishthana, Adhishthana Sakshi Chaitanya has lent its Purana and thereby Vishayitvam also appears to be there in this Chidabhasa Rupa Pramata who is reflected in the Ahankara. So Ahankara being the Visheshana, you are misunderstanding it there. That is the idea there. So Ithi Avipretya Aha Dehamiti. Athava otherwise another way to look at it which is seen in the ratna prabha athava ahankare satyeva chaitanyapi vishishte deham janami iti vishayita tadabhave tadabhavat it anvyaviti iti anvyaviti rekabhyam vishishte praptam vishayitvam parevasanad visheshanasya ahankarasya eva iti avipretya aha dehamiti So at Vishayitvam, or the other way to look at it as what? No, Ahankara is the Vishayi there. So this is the Puropakshi objecting, which is what is seen in the Ratna Prabha. The earlier perspective which was given was from the Siddhanti's perspective. As to explanation as to how it appears to be. But still the Puropakshi can misunderstand. Now, in the second interpretation, what is said? Athava ahankare satyeva chaitanye. So, satyeva chaitanye api. Vishishte deham janami iti vishayita. So, this ahankara being there. So, the flip side. In the ahankara, you see vishayitvam which is from the chaitanya. Without chaitanya, you cannot have vishayitvam also. In fact, in Shuddha Chaitanya, there cannot be Vishayitvam also. Just like in Kevala Ahankara, there cannot be Vishayitvam. However, to differentiate it has to be shown, Sakshitvena. So that Vishayitvam is Sakshi, as a Sakshi. Because Atma is Asanga. There cannot be Vishay Vishay Sambandha also really. In any case, the other way to look at it is, since the Vishayitvam is also not possible unless there is a mix-up. Therefore, in Chaitanya, what you see, that is due to the influence of Ahankara. The other way, flip side also is possible to be looked at. Because Guna Guneshu Vartante. When it has a Guna Guneshu Vartante, when Bhagavan Krishna said that, what is that? That is Vishay Vishayi Bhava. Guna Guneshu Vartante, Vishay Vishayi Bhava, Chaitanya has nothing to do with it. So taking that into perspective, athva ahankare satyeva chaitanya api vishishte. The Chaitanya is Vishishta, Visheshana is Ahankara. So only when this Visheshana Ahankara is there, then alone, in Chaitanya also, which is Vishishta, Deham Janamiti Vishayita Bhavati. This Vishayita, as Deham Janami, is in the Chaitanya Aryadi, which is only when the Ahankara becomes a Visheshana to that Chaitanya and thereby makes this Chidabhasa as Pramata. Thereby there is a Phalita Chaitanya. And this Pratiphalita Chaitanya Chidabhasa is objectifying the Deha and claiming as Deham Janami. So you don't know where to put this Vishayitvam, in Ahankara or Chaitanya. If you put it in Chaitanya also, then it is due to Ahankara. So Purvapakshi is saying, okay, can you show me Vishayitvam of Chaitanya without Ahankara? In any case, you cannot show. Therefore, what is the conclusion? That Vishayitvam that you are claiming, you the Siddhanti, that is also due to Ahankara. Therefore, there is no Virodha. Tamah Prakashat Virodha cannot be shown between Ahankara and Atma. Tadatma Sambandha is there. Unless Ahankara becomes a Visheshana to Chaitanya, you cannot show this Vishayitvam also. Therefore, you have Anvaya Vyatirika now. Tadbhave Tadbhavat. Tadbhave Tadbhavat. Tadbhave Tadbhavat. Meaning, Ahankara Bhave Vishayitva Bhavaha. Ahankara Abhave. Meaning, when the Visheshana Ahankara Bhave Sati, Vishayitva Bhavaha. And Visheshana Ahankara Abhave Sati, Vishayitva Abhava. So, Anvaya Vyatirika is there. What is the Anvaya? When Ahankara is there, then only Chaitanya has Vishayitvam. When Ahankara isn't there, then Chaitanya does not have Vishayitvam. Therefore, Ahankara makes or breaks this Vishayitvam in the Chaitanya. That being so, iti Anvaya Vyatireka Abhyam Vishishte Praptam Vishayitvam Paryavasanat Visheshanasya Ahankarasya Eva. This Vishayitvam that you are claiming to be there in Atma, it is only due to Ahankara. So he is using the similar logic that Siddhanti uses. Siddhanti says that, do you see Satta in anything? Yes, that is borrowed Satta from Atma. Why so? Because whenever Atma is there, then only there is Satta is there. Whenever you are Sakshi to any Ghata, then only Ghata can be seen. You cannot claim to know anything unless you have seen it. You have heard it. You have tasted it. You have touched it. You have smelled it. All these Padarthas which exist, you know only by their Gunas. And those gunas you know via your indriyas. These indriyas you know, they function because of your presence. Even the shabda pramana, you trust someone else. That someone else is cognized and given reality by you. So that you, the Sakshi Chaitanya, lacking, there is a lack of anything and everything. Only when you, the Sakshi Chaitanya, is there, then only you can validate the presence and bhana. Satta and Bhana of anything. Therefore, what do we prove? We the Siddhantis prove that Satta and Spurti is borrowed by the entire Prapancha, Ahankaradi Prapancha, does not have its own. Similarly, now that argument is turned around on the Siddhanti by the Purvapakshi, and he says that since without Ahankara you cannot have Atma as Vishayi, Chaitanya as Vishayi, therefore Atma's Vishayitvam, Chaitanya's Vishayitvam is also Ahankara's. Ahankarasya eva iti avipretyah dehamiti. And therefore he says deham janamiti dehankarayor vishay vishayitvayapi manushyamiti abheda adhyasavad atma ahankarayapi adhyasasyadityataha chidatmaketi. So this is what we have seen with the second interpretation also. What will happen is that Purvapakshi will be able to conclude that whether or not it is due to Ahankara, there can be Tadatmya Sambandha. So, he expects that the Siddhanti will say no, there is this अहंकार डज नॉट हैव इट्स ओन विषयित्व ऑल्सो. सो वट एवर बी दी आंसर, ही सेज तादात्म्य संबंध इज देयर, इट इज अपियरिंग इन दी आत्मा ड्यू टू अहंकार. विदाउट अहंकार इट के नॉट अपियर इन दी आत्मा ऑल्सो, इवन इफ इट इज मुख्य इट के नॉट अपियर. सो तादात्म्य संबंध इज डेफिनेटली देयर. सॉरी, देयर फॉर विरोध इज एंड देयर. तयोर जाड्याल्पत्वाभ्याम सादृश्याद अध्यासेपि चिदात्मनि अनवच्छिन्ने जडाल्प अहंकारादेर न अध्यासेति भावः. सो व्हाट इज बीइंग सेड दैट दिस देयर इज अ डिफरेंस. वी सॉ दैट देयर इज अ डिफरेंस इन द एग्जांपल एंड द एग्जेम्प्लीफाइड इन द फर्स्ट इंटरप्रिटेशन गिवन इन द रत्नप्रभा. सो दैट इज व्हाट वी हैव टू लुक एट. तयोः जाड्याल्पत्वाभ्याम सादृश्य सादृश्याद अध्यासे अपि. सो बिटवीन द पूर्वपक्षीज एग्जाम्पल एग्जाम्पल एलिमेंट्स इन द बिटवीन द टू इन अ पेयर ऑफ देह एंड अहंकार. सो तयोः देह अहंकारयोः तयोः कयोः देह अहंकारयोः बिटवीन देह एंड अहंकार इन द एग्जाम्पल पेयर ऑफ द पूर्वपक्षी देर इज जड़त्वम एंड अल्पत्वम. देह इज जड़ एंड अल्प लिमिटेड इनसेंशियंट एंड अहंकार इज ऑल्सो लिमिटेड एंड इट इज ऑल्सो इनसेंशियंट. सो जड़ अल्पत्वाभ्याम अध्यास स्याद सादृश्य. सो सादृश्य इज देर ड्यू टू सादृश्य अध्यास इज पॉसिबल. You don't see the Rajju as Rajata. You see Rajju as Sarpa. You don't see Shukti as Sarpa. You see Shukti as Rajata. There, what is the reason? One of the reasons is there should be some kind of Sadrishyam. There should be some similarity. There is no similarity between rope and silver. Therefore, rope does not appear as silver. Rope appears as Sarpa because Sarpa has similarities in the shape etc with rope. Here also jadatvam between deha and ahankara there can be tadatmya adhyasa. We do not say no. Why? Because sadrishya is there, jadatvam is similar, alpatvam is similar. However, adhyase api in the exemplified case chidatmani anavachinne जड़ाल्प जड़ अल्प अहंकारादेर न अध्यास इति भावः. बिटवीन द एग्जेम्प्लीफाइड एलिमेंट्स ऑफ द पेयर विच आर द चिदात्मा एंड द अहंकार विच इज जड़ अचित. सो आत्मा इन द आत्मा देर के नॉट बी जड़त्व अहंकार जड़ अहंकार अध्यास. सो इन द चिदात्मा अचित अहंकार अध्यास कैनॉट बी देर. देर इज नो सादृश्य. वन इज चित, वन इज अचित. सो अनवच्छिन्न आत्मनि दिस आत्मा विच इज नॉट सेगमेंटेड बाय एनी उपाधि और विशेषण. इन दैट आत्मा दैट शुद्ध आत्मा इज वॉट वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट एज चिदात्मके. इन दैट चिदात्मा अस्मत् प्रत्यय गोचर आत्मा देर कैनॉट बी अध्यास ऑफ जड़ अल्प अहंकार. जड़ अल्प अहंकार कैन बी कंफ्यूज विद जड़ अल्प देह बट जड़ अल्प अहंकार कैनॉट बी कंफ्यूज विद आत्मा. यू कैनॉट हैव अध्यास ऑफ दैट ऑन आत्मा इति भाव. अहम इति भाष्यत्वाद आत्मवत अहंकारस्य अपि प्रत्यक्त्वादिकं मुख्यमेव ततः पूर्वोक्त पराक्तत्वाद्य सिद्धिर इत्याशंक्य आह युष्मदिति. विल कम बैक टू दिस. विल सी व्हाट द टीकाकार सेज. दिस इज अनदर ऑब्जेक्शन रेज्ड बाय द पूर्वपक्षी. टीका. मनुष्य पदम देह विशेषण परम. व्हाट इज मनुष्यत्वम. मनुष्य व्हेन यू से मनुष्य देन इट इज मनुष्य देह. इट इज नॉट मनुष्य आत्मा. इट इज नॉट मनुष्य एनीथिंग एल्स. इट इज मनुष्य देह. देयरफॉर मनुष्य पदम देह विशेषण परम. What it means is that manushya means deha itself. Manushyattvam jati vishesha. There the deha visheshena jati visheshattvam. Manushya is a jati. Manushya jati. Prani jati. Pakshi jati. So they are a set of species which is known only by the deha. So deha visheshana param manushyatvam jati vishesha deha nishta samsthana visheshatma dharmo va, or what? Manushyatvam can be jati as per Nayayika. And jati is nitya as per Nayayika. We don't agree with that. We don't need to agree with that. So it is okay. Jati is there. It's okay. What is this jati? If the Nayayika says jati is nitya, so aneka gatam ekam nityam. That is jati. We say we don't agree with all that. Aneka gatam and all that is fine, but this nityatvam and all that we don't agree with. So we say that other interpretation of this manushyatvam need not be in keeping with Nayayika's jati. It can be something else. What is that? Deha nishta samsthana vishesha atmaka dharma hava. So atmaka means bahuri. So it is what? Atma is swarupa there. So vishesha swarupa. Deha nishta samsthana vishesha. There is something which is there in the deha. What is that something? Some vishesha is there and vishesha rupa is there. Something that you can identify, cognize. That kind of a dharma vishesha, some dharma vishesha is there. So vishesha rupa dharma is there. Or the dharma has some vaishishyam. That is its swarupa, which reveals to you that this deha is manushya deha, that deha is prani deha ityadi. Manushya is also prani, but then we'll say pakshi deha, for example. So pakshi deha, pakshi and manushya are different. Why? Because deha vishesha dharma are different. That can be the interpretation of manushyattva. Tad vishishtasya dehasya. Now this is a vishesha dharma, manushyattva. That manushya dharma is in deha. So thereby we say that deha is what is meant. When you say deham aham janami, then you know that you are manushya. There manushya and deha are interchangeable that way. Tad vishishtasya, meaning manushyatva vishishtasya dehasya cittadatmyapanna ahankarasya cha manushya aham iti abhedadhyasavad ityartha. So when you say deham aham janami and deha and ahankara has tadatmya sambandha, what is that? That is as manushya. I am manushya. So aham manushya. When you say deha has tadatmya sambandha with ahankara, then ahankara is aham iti. Ahamkara, ahamkriti ahamkara. So that ahamkriti, aham, that kriti which is there, ahamkriti, that aham, the yatna which is going on as aham, before you make up any prayatna, this aham comes up in the antakarna. You claim yourself to be some kind of an entity manifesting in the antakarna. In your thinking, you are a particular entity. For right or wrong. In Vyavahara also, for right or wrong. From Paramarthika perspective, definitely wrong. But still, in Vyavahara, for right or wrong, you have an idea in the mind that I am this kind of a person. And then you say that manushya aham. And then you will get led into all sorts of Vyavaharas. So tad vishishtasya dehasya chidatmya apanna ahankarasya cha. This ahankara is not that ahankara which is claiming manushya aham by itself. Why? Because chittadatmya apanna ahankara it is. The ahankara cannot go and have a tadatmya sambandha with the deha unless it has already had a tadatmya sambandha with the chaitanya. Therefore, this ahankara which is there in the sukshma sharira, meaning the sukshma sharira which is there, which goes from loka to loka after the death of the sharira is as it is. But what is this mrityu? Mrityu is the prana going away. Prana is the part of the sukshma sharira. So this sukshma sharira, which has prana, that prana goes away and takes the sukshma sharira also, leaving the stula sharira elsewhere behind. Chaitanya is all pervasive. But the chaitanya and the sukshma sharira तादात्म्य वॉज देयर इवन बिफोर जन्म एंड दैट जन्म इज द एसोसिएशन ऑफ दैट सूक्ष्म शरीर विच हैज प्रतिफलित चैतन्य मीनिंग चैतन्य तादात्म्य संबंध इज ऑलरेडी देयर देयर फोर चित्तादात्म्य चैतन्य चित्त मीन्स चैतन्य चित्तादात्म्य चैतन्य तादात्म्यापन्न अहंकारस्य च देहस्य एंड द स्थूल देह गेट्स करेक्टेड इन जन्म सो द सूक्ष्म शरीर एंटरिंग द स्थूल शरीर इज जन्म बट व्हाट काइंड ऑफ सूक्ष्म शरीर दैट सूक्ष्म शरीर विच इज ऑलरेडी एसोसिएटेड विथ चैतन्य विथ तादात्म्य संबंध भेद सहित अभेद देन देर इज भेद सहित अभेद ऑफ दिस कॉन्ग्लोमरेट विद द स्थूल शरीर दैट इज जन्म सो इवन वेन यू से देहम अहम जानामि दैट टाइम दिस अहंकार हैज तादात्म्य संबंध विथ चैतन्य वेयर बाय देर इज अ भ्रांति ऑफ सेंशियंस इन द अहंकार एंड देयर बाय दैट गेट्स लेड टू द देह ऑल्सो If you pinch, you can feel it and you think that the Deha is Chetana only because of this Spurana extending from the Chaitanyatma to the Deha via Ahankara. So Ahankara by itself can loan out nothing. Cannot lend out anything. It cannot lend Chaitanya to the Deha. This Tadatma Sambandha with the Deha is possible only after Tadatma Sambandha of the Ahankara. With the Atma. Thereby, tad vishishtasya dehasya manushyatva vishishtasya dehasya chittadatmya panna ahankarasya cha manushya aham iti abheda adhyasava dityartha. So, like that adhyasa, in the Purvapakshi's objection itself, what is being done? The Siddhanti is adding this in the Tika as to this ahankara is also having chaitanya. So Purvapakshi says, then I don't need to prove anything. You already have accepted that there is a tadatmya sambandha. So there is no virodha. So yatra vishaya vishayitvam tatra abheda adhyasa bhavaha yatha deepa ghatavat. So yatha is not needed if you say deepa ghatavat. Or yatha deepa ghataha. Iti ukta niyamaha. So the niyama was already stated. What was it? यत्र विषय विषयित्व वेर देर इज विषय विषयित्व संबंध विषय विषयित्व संबंध इज देर देर तादात्म्य संबंध इज नॉट पॉसिबल दीपा इज अ विषय वेर एज घटा इज अ विषय डू यू हैव कंफ्यूजन बिटवीन दीपा एंड घटा यू नेवर हैव इट तादात्म्य संबंध इज नॉट पॉसिबल देर फोर यत्र यत्र विषय विषयित्व संबंध तत्र तत्र अभेद अध्यासस्य अभावः You cannot have abheda adhyasa there. Tadatmya is not possible. Like the Deepa Ghata. Iti ukta niyama, that niyama which was stated, by the Siddhanta it was stated, ahankara vyatirikta staleva. This is applicable only in the ahankara vyatirikta stala. Not in all places, you can't extend it everywhere. अहंकार व्यतिरिक्त स्थलेव स नियम इति नियमस्य प्रथमापि शब्देन संकोच सूच्यते इति भावः सो दिस इज इंप्लाइड दैट इन द केसेस वेयर अहंकार इज नॉट इन्वॉल्व देयर यू कैन अप्लाई दिस नियम एज सून एज अहंकार कम्स इन टू प्ले ऑल सॉर्ट्स ऑफ थिंग्स आर पॉसिबल बिकॉज अहंकार इज द फर्स्ट मैनिफेस्टेशन ऑफ चैतन्य First manifestation. There is an unmanifest pratipalita chaitanya. You cannot call it pratipalita also because in avidya there is definitely pratibimba of chaitanya. In the karana sharira. Without that you cannot have in the sukshma sharira, in the buddhi, in the ahankara. But the manifested where vyavahara is possible, that kind of chaitanya manifest is available, that kind of adhyasa is there only in the Vijnanamaya kosha ahankara. That is the first. So it is implied there, as soon as ahankara comes into play, this niyama goes for a toss. Everywhere else it is applicable. But as soon as you bring ahankara into the equation, things change. Why? Because ahankara has a different, it claims sentience. there is something that happens there whereby this niyama is broken. So it's an exception to the rule. Further, alpatvam parichinnatvam adhyase sadrishyam hetuhu prakrutetu atmanatmanoho pruthak visheshanadvayena sadrishyabhavam upapadayan phalitamaha chiditi. This example case we have seen where jadatvam and alpatvam are sadrishya, are similarities, therefore there can be adhyasa. When you bring in chaitanya and ahankara as a pair, there sadrishyam is not there. One is mithya, the other is satya. Finally, that's what we'll say. But if you start looking at dharmas, we'll say one is chetana, other is achetana. At least that virodha we'll start with. So if you take even one virodha there, therefore there cannot be any tadatmya sambandha. Shouldn't be, that's the idea. There cannot be, there shouldn't be, but there is. That is the maya sarvasya sambhavat. Maya makes all this possible. Avidya, maya shakti makes all this possible. Which shouldn't be. So it is magical. We are looking at logical, not magical. So we say magical it is possible, logical it is not. And this entire grantha is a logical analysis. It is a nyaya prasthana. So how it is possible? It shouldn't be possible, but it is possible. It appears to be so. That is the analysis. So we are taking a logical approach and we say therefore, mithya bhavitum yuktam. It is logical to conclude that it is all false. So you go to a magic show and you see that, somebody on the stage, there is a small chair, there is nothing there, but suddenly this fellow makes an elephant appear there, standing on 1 foot. So something which is ridiculous, on a chair where you yourself cannot balance on one leg, he makes an elephant appear on this tiny chair and the elephant stands on one leg. Mithya bhavitum yuktam, it cannot be real. Let's say it's a circus elephant. Okay, circus elephant, but it wasn't there. How? Where did it come from? Magically it has come from nowhere. Suddenly appears, it has to be mithya. Logically it doesn't fit. So how do you explain it? Oh, I am a science student, I have to analyze this. You cannot analyze this. It appears. You can rub your eyes, you can pour water, you can pinch yourself to wake yourself up. But still, if you are there in a hypnotism show or a magical show, magic show, then what should you say? Mithya bhavitum yuktam. It is not real. That much you can say. By what all you know as pramana, you can say this is not real. Is it unreal then? Oh, you cannot say it is unreal. Why? Because you are seeing. And you are a person who says that I will believe only what I see. Having made such a tall claim, you go to a magic show and then all your beliefs fall apart. Then what do? You cannot say it is unreal. So what do you say? It is not real. I cannot say it is unreal, but still it is not real. So sadasad vilakshana. This is the magic here. And that is what we are landing on here through this introduction also, that is what we are landing on, slowly, but hopefully, surely. So, thereby, Chiditi, what he is saying is that in this pair, the exemplified pair, that is not possible, therefore, Chidatmani Ichyadi, we saw that. Anavachinna, in the Tika, Anavachinnatvam Aparichinnatvam, what is this? Atma, in the exemplified pair of Atma and Ahankara, this Atma Chidatmaka, is anavachinna chit. Anavachinna means aparichinna. It is not segmented by anything. Whether as a visheshana or an upadhi, it is not segmented. That kind of chaitanya we are talking about. Because you cannot have a segmented chaitanya and then talk about adhyasa, because segmented chaitanya means already adhyasa is accepted. You cannot jump the gun. So, what we are trying to prove is not possible. Having taken that as established, you cannot discuss adhyasa and refute it. It is like saying, having a tongue and saying that I can't speak. So having assumed that there is a tongue, having spoken, then you say I don't have a tongue. So that kind of case would be if you say that it is a parichinna chaitanya in the bhashya by Chidatmake. That is not true. It is aparichinna. Anavachinna means aparichinna. So anavachinnatvam, aparichinnatvam, vyapakatvam iti yavat. So it is a completely vyapakatattva. That Brahma Tattva is what is meant by Chaitanya here. It is not an individual Jiva Chaitanya, Jiva Gata Chaitanya, because Jiva is a result of this Adhyasa. Jivatvam is Adhyasta. You cannot say it is Jiva Chaitanya or Jiva Gata Chaitanya. You cannot say it. In this case, it is Shuddha Chaitanya, Sakshi Chaitanya, where you can talk about Upadhis also, but we are not discussing that at all right now. We are talking about that Shuddha Chaitanya, Kevala Chaitanya, and which does not have any upadhi or visheshana. Therefore it is anavachinna, aparichinna, and therefore vyapaka. Individuality can be shown only by the deha, antakkarana, etc. Now that is not there, so therefore it is shuddha brahma. That is what is being looked at by Chidatmake. Asmat pratyaya gochara is really that Brahma tattva on which there is an ahankara superimposition, and therefore there is segmentation also, and then deha bhava, manushya ityadi, all that is later, and that is being questioned. So ahankara, what about ahankara now? This ahankara which is taken in the in Ratna Prabha for discussion there, अहम इति भाष्यत्वात् आत्मवद् अहंकारस्यपि प्रत्यक्त्वादिकं मुख्यमेव. सिंस अहम यूसेज इज देयर इन दी अहंकार. अर्लियर व्हाट वाज द यूसेज? द यूसेज वाज शोन टू बी अहम इति प्रत्ययमानत्वम वाज शोन इन आत्मा. नाउ पूर्व पक्षी फ्लिप्स हिज आर्ग्यूमेंट, यूजेस सेम हेतु. ही सेज अहम इति भाष्यत्वात् प्रतीयमानत्वात् भाष्यत्वात्, सेम मीनिंग रियली. सो अहम इति भाष्यत्वात् आत्मवद्, जस्ट लाइक आत्मा दैट आई हैव शोन अर्लियर. अहंकारस्य अपि, इन द केस ऑफ अहंकार, सो इज स्वैपिंग द पक्ष एंड दृष्टांत, कीपिंग द हेतु सेम, एंड देयरफॉर व्हाट? प्रत्यक्त्वादिकं मुख्यमेव. कस्य? अहंकारस्य अपि. यू से अहम अहम, आत्मा इज अहम, आत्मा इज अहम. यू से ब्रह्म अहंतया सर्वेषु भाति, सर्वत्र भाति, सर्वेषु भाति. सो व्हेन यू से इन एवरीवन देयर इज अहम अहम अहम, दैट आत्मा इज प्रत्यंग आत्मा. आई कैन आल्सो से सर्वेषु अहंकारेषु अहम अहम, सर्वेषु देहेषु अहम अहम इति अहंकारः प्रतीयते. देयरफॉर अहमिति भासमानत्वात् अहंकारस्य अहमिति भासमानत्वम्, तस्मात् अहंकारस्य अपि प्रत्यक्त्वं भवतु. सो वाय प्रत्यगात्मा? वाय नॉट से प्रत्यग अहंकार? सेम हेतु. देयरफॉर अहंकार, अहंकारस्य प्रत्यक्त्वं इज आल्सो मुख्य. सो व्हेन यू आर डूइंग कोश विवेक, व्हेन एज सून एज यू land on manomaya kosha, vijnanamaya kosha, sukshma sharira, basically from annamaya kosha, you stop there. There is nothing else needed. Why? Because aham prayoga is there as well. So why not ahankara be pratyak mukhyatvena? Tataha purvokto paraktvadya siddhir ityashankya ah yushmariti. Therefore what? Your virodha that you are showing by saying one is outward, the other is inward. Ahankara is outward. No, ahankara is also inward. Therefore, between inward ahankara and inward atma, there cannot be any virodha. So, vastuta virodha, swabhavata virodha, which was shown, that is also questionable due to this hetu. So, thereby, ahankara, his anumana is ahankara pratyaktvavan, aham iti bhasyamanatvat. आत्मवत्. सो अहंकारा इज पक्ष, इज साध्य, इज प्रत्यक्त्वत्वम्, एंड हेतु इज अहमिति भाष्यमानत्वम्. सो अहमिति भाष्यमानत्वम् बिकम्स हेतु साधना एंड हिज दृष्टांत इज आत्मवत यथा आत्मा. सो नाउ अहम इति भाष्य त्वम इति यह हेतु उक्तः. द हेतु व्हिच हैज बीन गिवन हियर, व्हाट इज द मीनिंग? सो दिस इज क्वेश्चन बाय द सिद्धांती. इज इट? सो इफ यू गो फर्दर, अहम वृत्ति भाष्यत्वम अहंकारे नास्ति, कर्तृकर्मत्व विरोधात् चिद् भाष्यत्वम चिदात्मनि नास्ति इति हेतु असिद्धि. अगेन हेतु असिद्धि इज बीइंग शोन इन दिस अनुमान आल्सो बाय मेकिंग टू डिविजन्स. व्हाट इज द डिविजन हियर? द डिविजन इज नॉट मेंशनड हियर. सो बाय द रिफ्यूटेशन यू हैव टू टेक द पक्षास क्रिएटेड बाय द सिद्धांती. सो सिद्धांती आस्क्स द पूर्व पक्षी, विल स्टॉप आफ्टर दिस. I'll just go through this and then stop. Pratyaktvadikam mukhyam, that is your sadhya, but what is your hetu? Aham iti bhasyamanatvam. So aham iti bhasyamanatvam, is it aham vritti bhasyatvam or is it bhasyatvam. So aham iti bhasyatvam, what is the meaning of aham iti bhasyatvam, this hetu? Is it aham vritti bhasyatvam or chid bhasyatvam? Is it aham vritti bhasyatvam or chid bhasyatvam? Based on that, we'll analyze. So if you say adya, you say aham iti bhasyatvam means aham vritti bhasyatvam, then tanna, that is not possible. Why? What is vritti? Vritti is ahankara parinama. So ahankara parinama is vritti and aham vritti bhasyatvam is not possible in ahankara, because ahankara itself is vritti. So vritti will not lead you to ahankara, because vritti is ahankara. So there is a hetu asiddhi there. What about the other interpretation, chidbhasyatvam? Chidbhasyatvam, okay, chidbhasyatvam is there. So you say ahankara is chidbhasya. You know it is a chidvishya. Chidbhasya means chidvishya. So aham iti bhasyatvam is chidbhasyatvam, and that is there in ahankara. Okay, it is there in ahankara. So what? Your drishtanta is atma. In atma it isn't there. In atma, aham iti bhasyatvam is not chidbhasyatvam. That isn't there. Aham iti bhasyatvam is not there. It is itself chit. So Chaitanya is not Chidbhasya. Chaitanya is Swayam Prakasha. Does not need another Chaitanya to light it up. It does not need its own Chaitanya to light it up, because there is Karma Kartru Virodha. Therefore, Aham Vritti Bhasyatvam Ahankare Nasti. In Ahankara, if you say, okay, it is Ahankara Bhasya Ahankara, that also you cannot say. Kartru Karmatva Virodha. Because what is the meaning of kartru karma virodha here? Aham vritti bhasya ahankara, if you say aham vritti is ahankara, and aham vritti bhasya ahankara means ahankara bhasya ahankara, that is kartru karma virodha. Therefore aham vritti bhasyatvam is not there in ahankara. Therefore the meaning of aham iti bhasyatvam cannot be aham vritti bhasyatvam. If you say chidbhasyatvam, is the meaning chidatmani nasti. In chidatma there is no aham iti bhasyatvam, meaning chidbhasyatvam isn't there. Iti hetva siddhi. Ataha buddhyadehe pratibhasata pratyaktve api paraktvadikam mukhyamev iti bhava. So the even if you have this aham iti bhasyamanatvam in ahankara, that is still outward, that aham is pratyam by bhranti. There is paraktvam, because if you go further, you will land on the understanding that atma is the only inward tattva, ahankara is outward, not inward. So we'll look at the tika in the next part. Yamiha karunikam gatopyari sahodarapamahatpadam tamaham आशु हरम हरिम परमाश्रय जनक जांग कमनंत सुखाकृति. एनी क्वेश्चंस? नमस्कार.